Hi friends, welcome to MacRocks. Today we will discuss about how to find the support reactions of a simple supported beam with UDL. So this is a simple supported beam, supports at A and B. We are applying the uniformly distributed loop. For this we are finding the support reaction. First we see the problem. A simply supported beam AB of length 9 meters carries a uniformly distributed load of 10 kN per meter for a distance of 6 meters from left end A. Calculate support reactions at A and B. The given simple support beam AB of length 9 meters carries uniformly distributed load. That's also called the UDL. 10 kN per meter. What is the meaning of this one? For 1 meter, 10 kN acting. Okay. And at a distance of 6 meters from left end. From left end, this acting 6 meters. You have to find the what is the support reaction at A, what is the support reaction at B. For example, I am assuming support reaction at A is the RA. Support reaction at B is the RB. Now we have to find the RA value, RB value. Before that one, first we have to find the what is the total load acting. Total load equal to what is the load per unit meter? 10 kilometers. How much is the length? 6. 10 into 6, that is the 60 kilonewtons. Total load acting at the 60 newtons. For 1 meter, 10 kilonewtons acting. For 6 meter, 10 into 6, 60 kilonewtons. Now, we have to apply the equilibrium conditions. First, you apply the sigma Fi equal 0. Why only sigma Fi? The force acting only along the y-axis. That's why you are applying the sigma Fi. Okay. Now, first it is the RA. RA acting upward. That is a positive. Next, you consider the UDL. What is the value of UDL? 60. But is acting downward. That is a minus 60. Now, RB acting upward. Arrow upwards. That is a positive. Plus RB. That is equal to 0. Now, you bring 60 to the side. RA plus RB equal to 60 kilonewtons. To find the RA value, RB value, we have to apply one more equilibrium condition. That is the sigma M equal to 0. Okay. Sigma M means all the sum of the moments. But you have to take one reference point. And moments about either A or B or C. I am taking A. Sum of the moments about A equal to 0. Sum of the all the moments on the beam AB is equal to 0. First you consider the RA. RA into what is the distance between RA and A? 0. Why? RA passing through the point A. Next you consider the UDL. What is the UDL? 60 into this load, the total load acting at midpoint of C. Midpoint of C. The UDL acting at midpoint of C. Midpoint of C means what is from the A distance how much? 6 by 2. Okay. This total load acting at midpoint of C. Midpoint of C means the total length AC. Then midpoint means 6 by 2. Now this is the minus. Okay. Or you consider like this. If you consider the clockwise as negative movement. Okay. This is a clockwise movement. Maybe like this now. I am taking clockwise movement as the negative. Clockwise movement means force into distance. This is the force and this is the distance. Now, what is the next force? RB. RB into what is the distance between A and RB? 9. Now, this is acting along like this. This is a anti-clockwise direction. That is a positive. That equal to 0. RA into 0 means 0 minus 2 1 2, 3, 30. 30 and 60, 180. 180 plus RB into 9 is equal to 0. Then RB equal to, you bring 180 that side, 9 comes down. That equal to RB equal to 20 newtons. Now, RA plus RB equal to 60. RA plus RB the 20, that equal to 60. RA equal to 60 minus 20. That equal to 40. Kilonewtons. RA value is the 40 kilonewtons, RB value is the 20 kilonewtons. These are kilonewtons. Like this, you can find the support reactions of a simple supported beam when UDL acting. Thank you for watching my video.